So, hello everyone, welcome to this quick update here. I thought it was a nice idea. I hope you think that too, to give you once in a while a short update of what's going on here, what are the plans, what are the expectations, what you can expect of this channel, what we are going to do anyways. The most important thing that I want to share with you today is I want you to take your agenda and mark the day of 2nd of March, because that's the day on which you're going to find the release of the Beethoven Hammerklavier Sonata on our channel. So next week, Alberto Sanna is coming over here to for a recording session, and one of the pieces is the Hammerklavier Sonata of Beethoven. Actually, it was the piece that he was working on and was giving him the idea of the impulse really to connect with me, because he wanted to play it on one of these pianos. Back then there was a Frenzel only. And so he's coming over now and record the Hammerklavier Sonata here on this piano, on this Fritz pianoforte. That will be a game changer, that will be a milestone, and you don't want to miss that YouTube premiere. If you haven't been there live in a launch on YouTube on such a premiere, that's wonderful, because we have there a wonderful community waiting for you to interact with each other in the chat. We have now, as we speak, around 80 to 150 people there during a live stream. Actually, it's not a live stream, it's a premiere, it's a kind of semi-live. I am there in the chat as well as Alberto Sanna, and so there is really a nice community that hangs out with each other while the music is playing. So 2nd of March, no reason to skip that. 7:30 p.m. is every Monday here on YouTube. And as much as I cannot promise you that we will hit every Monday with a major release of a piece that's worth a premiere, so to say, in length, because it's not, I mean, we're not premiering pieces that are under, let's say, 20 minutes, but we will make, I think we can manage to do that a lot of times. So 7:30, 2nd of March, 7:30 p.m. here Central European time. That is about 1:30 in Eastern time. So mark that day. It's not the first Hammerklavier Sonata recording that's online available. That honor is to be given to Wolfgang Weller. He made two versions of the Hammerklavier Sonata in live performances, I think even way back 2004 or something like that. Both versions are to be found on his channel. But this will be the first kind of studio recording on period instrument. So Alberto will be also recording, I don't know if this camera can see here, and the dog here on this Frenzel piano, on which he just released the Kinderszene of Schumann. He will be recording Schumann's Kinderszene again, now in Clara Schumann's tempi, and also in Otto Böhm's tempo, both of course in the WBMP. And there with those recordings, we will have solved also a lot, quote unquote, mysteries. So other than that, he is doing also the Opus 7, E flat major. And we are both doing, besides the Beethoven symphonies. Oh, did I mention the Beethoven symphony? I don't know, but here it is. I'm thinking so much on this project that I forgot to share it with you now. So this is the entire, all the Beethoven symphonies, this complete book, this property of Lorenz Guardian, this is very heavy, of Czerny's transcriptions for hand of Beethoven symphonies. And we are going to start, guess with which is, symphony? Yes, with the fifth one. So that will be available probably after the Hammerklavier Sonata, I don't know. And other than that, we will record also the Schubert famous F minor fantasy for four hands. There are no metronome numbers for that, but Lorenz Guardian made a reconstruction for us. So that will be in Lorenz Guardian's tempi, so that will be cool. So you may ask what I'm working on. So besides some pieces for this piano I was practicing here now, so now if you can see it, probably not, some Czerny etudes, part 3 of the Opus 299 is coming in a few, I don't know, let's not give a date for that. I like practicing those etudes in the morning or just when I start playing the piano. It's a wonderful warming up for the fingers. Then I'm working on Beethoven's Seventh Symphony. You've been asking a lot. Here it is, Hummel. But that's a big project to record. That will come once. Not promising you when, but it will come. I'm working on the Appassionata Sonata, yes. Also, that will be for after the Hammerklavier Sonata. And other than that, I am practicing again on this, which is, of course, my clavichord. I miss that instrument more than I can say. And you've been asking for such a long time to bring the clavichord back, and of course I wanted to do that. But first I had to develop my touch for this piano, and I will be sharing the difference between the clavichord and the pianoforte, which is a bigger difference than I could have anticipated. So honestly, coming from the clavichord to the pianoforte, that's okay, but of course the pianoforte requires another touch. Again, I'm not going to go into detail here, that's for another video. But going back from the pianoforte to the clavichord is really hard. And so I'm now training myself to go from the clavichord to the pianoforte and back, and see that I can, each time I do that, reach the level I want to have. So that is certainly something for some other videos, and that will be cool. I have learned a lot by introducing the pianoforte and then going back to the clavichord. Learned a lot on the pianoforte technique and on the clavichord technique. It makes you aware of things that you otherwise do automatically. So all those things are coming up, and there is something else, namely that we will have another young pianist from the Netherlands, Laurens de Man, who is coming over, and he's going to record some etudes by Louis Berger, also on the Fritz. Louis Berger, I didn't know him. I don't think many of you will know him, but I can assure you, once you heard those etudes, you will be blown away. That's a mixture between Mendelssohn and Chopin, and honestly, that bundle of etudes is of the same level. And Laurens is a wonderful pianist, about same age as Alberto. So that will be for the week of the 17th February. He's coming over, also recording some waltzes of Schubert in Czerny's Waltz Tempo, of course, in WBMP. And finally, a few weeks ago, not last week, but the week before, we recorded here the Beethoven Trio Opus 38. And it's pretty windy outside, bad weather. Anyway, the Beethoven Trio Opus 38, which is a reduction by Beethoven himself in a trio version of the septet. We had a wonderful clarinetist, Massimiliano Miani, and a wonderful cellist, Renaud Kernua. And I don't have to tell you how intense this week was, not only practicing, rehearsing. It's, of course, a new practice for both musicians. And playing together, recording everything, we had three camera setups, and I think that week I had about 300 gigabytes on data, video and audio. So we are going through the editing now, which is of course a heavy process because we have to match the videos with the audio, but that will be something I don't know, I will announce that, will be something for March or even May. So once the date for that has been set, that I will certainly update you on that, because together with the Hammerklavier Sonata, that will be a second milestone this year. And so a lot of exciting projects, a lot of energy. I will update you on the book with Laurens and another update that's for later. So a lot of things are happening, coming together in this year. It's 2020, it's Beethoven year. You know, for me, these celebration years are not meaning so much, but I can guess it gives some attention generally for a composer. And that's coming together here on this channel this year. We're working also on a new website, on having the YouTube recordings and other recordings released on Bandcamp for download, on CD Baby, going through Spotify, to Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, and I don't know what other platforms you have. All of that we're working on, but also that is for another time. So the takeaway from this update is mark the day, 2nd of March, Hammerklavier Sonata played by Alberto Sanna and Beethoven's Tempi according or interpreted according to the WBMP, and that will be a milestone in what we think is, well, a reconstruction of the pre-industrial way of musicianship, perhaps. So also on that, I will update you in another video because there are some plans there too. Okay, stay tuned for that. No better way than to subscribe, of course. And if you haven't clicked on the bell, please do that, because that's the way that YouTube keeps you notified for future updates, so you don't miss those updates. If you're not familiar also with the premieres, you will get a notification once I set the premiere, and also 30 minutes before the premiere happens. So that's two notifications for one video, but that's what it is. And again, for the Hammerklavier Sonata, you don't want to miss that. Okay, thanks for being here with us on this journey, guys, and we see each other very soon again. Bye.